हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर प्लस टू केमिस्ट्री क्लास एंड टुडे विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर बायोमोलिक्यूल्स। बायोमोलिक्यूल्स आर द ऑर्गेनिक मॉलिक्यूल्स दैट आर इन्वॉल्व्ड इन द मेंटेनेंस एंड मेटाबॉलिक प्रोसेस ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड दे बिल्ड अप द लिविंग सिस्टम एंड रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर देयर ग्रोथ एंड मेंटेनेंस। दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। कॉमन बायोमोलिक्यूल्स, फर्स्ट वन इज कार्बोहाइड्रेट। दीज आर द पॉलीहाइड्रोक्सी एल्डिहाइड और कीटोन्स, और दीज आर द कंपाउंड्स विच अपॉन हाइड्रोलिसिस प्रोड्यूस पॉलीहाइड्रोक्सी एल्डिहाइड्स और कीटोन्स, एंड दीज आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द सैकराइड्स। सैकराइड्स मीन्स द सैक्रम वर्ड विच मीन्स शुगर, ड्यू टू इट्स अ स्वीट टेस्ट दैट मीन्स अ शुगर। सैक्रम वर्ड, सैक्रम इज फ्रॉम द सैक्रम, इट इज दीज आर नोन एज ए सैकराइड्स। Now classification of carbohydrates, these are of mainly three types. First one is monosaccharides, disaccharides and polysaccharides. First is monosaccharides. Monosaccharides are those saccharides which cannot get hydrolyzed into simpler molecules. For example, glucose, fructose and galactose. These are the examples which cannot hydrolyzed into simpler compounds, who are known as the monosaccharides. Second are the disaccharides. Disaccharides are that yield 2 or 10 monosaccharides units on hydrolysis. Means these are hydrolysis into different units of monosaccharides are known as the disaccharides. Examples like sucrose, lactose, maltose are the examples of disaccharides which are dissociate or hydrolyzed into different units of monosaccharides. Next one is the polysaccharides. Polysaccharides are the high molecular mass carbohydrates which on hydrolysis yield a large number of monosaccharides. So disaccharides, say disaccharides can yield into 2 or more than 2 monosaccharides, but polysaccharides can yield a large number of monosaccharides. For example, starch, cellulose and glycosans. These are the examples of polysaccharides. Now carbohydrates can be divided, like those carbohydrates which are soluble in water are known as sugars, which are soluble in water. On the periodic basis, these are divided into two types, reducing and non-reducing sugars. First one is the reducing sugar. Reducing sugar means are those carbohydrates which contain free aldehydic or ketonic group and reduced filling solution or tolerance reagent. Means those carbohydrates which gives test with the filling solution or with the tolerance reagent are known as the reducing sugars. For example, maltose and lactose, these are the examples. Second are the non-reducing sugars. Non-reducing sugars means which do not give test with the filling solution and tolerance reagent, which do not reduce filling solution and tolerance reagent are known as a non-reducing sugars. For example, is sucrose are the example of non-reducing sugar. Next is the glucose. Monosaccharide, it's the glucose is the monosaccharide carbohydrates with the general formula C6H12O6, and it is present in the sweet fruits and in honey. It is prepared from that C12H22O11 plus water. In the presence of sulfuric acid, it forms into glucose and fructose, C6H12 and O6. Next is starch. Starch is a carbohydrate. Its main sources are the wheat, rice, maize, potatoes. These are the main sources of starch, and it's amorphous powder. It's a form is amorphous. It is insoluble in cold water, polymer of glucose. It is a polymer of glucose, and it consists of two components, amylose and amylopectin. These are the two components from which it is formed. So it is a polymer of glucose, and two components of it is amylose and amylopectin are the two components of starch. Next is the cellulose. So cellulose is a linear polymer of beta glucose, and its main sources are wood, cotton. Main constituents of all cell wall is the cellulose, made up of cellulose. It is colorless. It does not reduce tolerance reagent. It means it is non-reducing in nature. It cannot be digested by the human stomach. Next is the glycogen. Carbohydrates stored in animal body is known as a glycogen, and it is also known as the animal starch. Why it is known as the animal starch? Because its structure is similar to the amylopectin, which is present in starch. Amylopectin and amylose, two units, and that is for starch was the polymer of glucose. So it is also known as a animal starch because its structure is similar to the amylopectin. It is present in that liver, muscles, enzymes. And when our body needs the glucose, enzymes breaks the glycogen down to the glucose, and that fulfill the need of body for the glucose. This is all about that carbohydrates, and next part we will do in the next session. Thank you.